Good morning. When we place a 1.00 kilogram mass on a spring, the end of the spring moves from the 34.4 centimeter mark to the 30.2 centimeter mark and comes to rest. I have two questions. Part A, what is the spring constant of the spring? And part B, what is the work done by the spring on the mass? Bobby, how do you think we should start this problem?
Flippin' physics!
Well, we know Hooke's law says that the force of a spring equals negative k times x, or the negative of the spring constant times the displacement from equilibrium position. So let's determine the displacement from equilibrium position.
It should be position final minus position initial. We should use meters instead of centimeters, so 0.302 minus 0.344, or negative 0.042 meters. That equals the x in Hooke's law equation for this situation.
Thanks, Bobby. Bo, what should we do from here?
Well, we can sum the forces in the y direction. That is the force of the spring.
Bo?
Yeah, what?
I think you forgot something.
What?
The free body diagram. You cannot sum the forces until you have drawn the free body diagram.
Right. Yeah. Sorry about that. In the free body diagram, the force of gravity is down and the force of the spring is up because the displacement of the mass is down and the force of the spring is always opposite the direction of the displacement from equilibrium.
That is what the negative in Hooke's law equation means.
Correct, Billy. Bo, please keep going.
Yeah. The net force in the y direction then equals the spring force minus force of gravity. The net force also equals mass times acceleration in the y direction. The mass is at rest, so its acceleration equals zero. That means the spring force equals the force of gravity. Substituting in equations gives us the spring constant times displacement from equilibrium position equals mass times acceleration due to gravity. We can solve for the spring constant and substitute in numbers to get 1 times 9.81 over 0.042, which equals 233.57, or 234 newtons per meter with 3 sig figs.
I thought the displacement from equilibrium position was negative 0.042 meters. Where did the negative go?
The negative has to do with the direction of the spring force. We already included the direction of the spring force when we drew the free body diagram and decided up was positive.
Right.
Okay, that is part A. Now we need to do part B. We need to determine the work done by the spring on the mass during this event. Billy, we currently have two equations for work. What are they? Which one are we going to use and why?
Two equations for work. Well, work equals the dot product of force and displacement, and work equals the integral from initial to final position of force in the x direction with respect to x. Which one do we use?
The dot product one is for work done by a constant force.
And the integral work equation we generally use when the work is done by a force which is not constant.
Okay, then is the force caused by a spring constant?
No. Hooke's law. The force of the spring changes depending on displacement from equilibrium position, so the spring force is not constant.
Right. Then we use the integral equation and not the dot product equation for work.
Very nice. Billy, please finish part B.
Certainly. The work done by the spring on the mass equals the integral from initial position to final position of the force of the spring with respect to x. So that equals the integral from 0 to negative 0.042 of negative spring constant times displacement from equilibrium position with respect to position. The integral of that is negative spring constant times displacement from equilibrium position squared all over 2, and we retain the same initial and final conditions. We need to take the final minus the initial of the integral. That works out to be negative 233.57 times negative 0.042 squared over 2 minus, well, the initial position is 0, so that whole term equals 0. That gives us 0.233.57 20601, or negative 0.206 joules with three sig figs.
Thank you, Billy. Bo, why is the work done by the spring force on the mass negative?
The work done by the spring force on the mass is negative because, well, the spring force is up and the displacement of the mass is down. Those two vectors are opposite in direction, so the work done on the mass by the spring is negative.
Correct. Okay, I need to point out that the work done by the spring on the mass equals the negative of 1 half times the spring constant times the displacement from equilibrium position squared. What is that? What is 1 half times the spring constant times displacement from equilibrium position squared?
Elastic potential energy.
Right.
That is correct. This is where the definition of elastic potential energy comes from. We have just derived the equation for elastic potential energy.
Yeah.
Nice. Cool.
And notice the work done by the spring on the mass is equal to the negative of the elastic potential energy stored in the spring. That means there is now elastic potential energy stored in the spring equal to 0.206 joules. And if we look at this in terms of area under a function, we can plot the equation for Hooke's law on axes of spring force on the vertical axis and displacement from equilibrium position on the horizontal axis. Hooke's law is represented by the blue line on the graph. When the spring is displaced a distance x from equilibrium position, the spring force has a magnitude of k times x. The area of the red triangle is the area under the function. The area of a triangle equals 1 half base times height, which equals 1 half times x times k times x, or 1 half times k times x squared, or elastic potential energy as we showed before using the integral, which I think is pretty cool. Thank you very much.
Actually, Mr. P, one last thing.
Nice. What is it, Bo?
The area you show there is positive 1 half base times height. However, the work done by the spring is negative 0.206 joules. Area under a function is positive above the x-axis, so what gives?
Yeah, we got a negative value for the work done by the spring. However, the area is above the x-axis on your graph, so it's positive. That does not make sense.
Oh, I think I get it. Remember that the concept that area above the x-axis is positive and the area below the x-axis is negative is only true when moving in a positive direction along the x-axis. In this case, we are taking the integral from 0 to negative 0.042 meters, so we are moving in the negative x direction. But the force is positive, so it ends up being negative work because the force and displacement are in opposite directions.
Sure, I get the physics, but what about the area of the triangle being equal to positive 1 half base times height, or positive 1 half kx squared? How does that area end up being negative?
It's the base. The base goes from 0 to negative x. Final minus initial means the base is negative x minus 0, or negative x. The area of the triangle then equals 1 half base times height, or 1 half times negative x times kx, which equals negative 1 half k times x squared.
Okay, I see it now. The area and work when going from negative x to 0 equals positive 1 half kx squared. That is the work done by the spring when lifting the mass up to equilibrium position. The area and work when going from 0 to negative x equals negative 1 half kx squared. That is the work done by the spring when lowering the mass down from equilibrium position.
Yeah. Thank you all. And Bo, thanks for that one last thing. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.